signals, four basic signals. There are so many classifications in signals and system, causal, non-causal, variant, time invariant. There are different, that is, you can study in signals and system subject. But with respect to controls from applications, we have four basic signals or four fundamental signals in signals and systems. Those are impulse signal, first one, impulse. Second one, step signal. Third one, ramp signal. Fourth one, parabolic signal. In time domain, reference input can be written as R of t. First we have to write in time domain. Impulse can be represented mathematically simply del of t. In signals and systems, you will understand all these things. How to represent impulse signal is del of t. Step signal is unit step signal. Not only step, it can be written as unit step. Always magnitude of step input is 1 if they are not given. If they are given, according to that magnitude, you have to understand. Now, step signal, unit step signal magnitude is 1, 1 into u of t. Next, ramp signal. Ramp can be written as t into u of t, where u of t in all the things is just inbuilt function. In signals and systems, you'll study. Even you are writing u of t or not writing u of t, there is no difference in meaning. Next, parabolic signal can be represented by t square by 2 into u of t. Right? Now, Laplace of r of t. As we are discussing controls from in S domain, convert into S domain. Laplace of r of t is r of s. Laplace of del of t is 1. Laplace of del of t is 1. Laplace of 1 is, already we have understand, 1 by s. Laplace of t is, already I have explained, 2 by s cube. Sorry, 1 upon s square. Already we know. Laplace of t power n. N factorial upon s power n plus 1. Laplace of t power 0. That means in place of n, 0. 0 factorial means 1 upon s power 0 plus 1, 1. Laplace of t power 0 is 1. Laplace of 1 is 1 by s. I written there. Laplace of t power 1. In place of n, 1. 1 factorial by s power 1 plus 1 square. Laplace of t square. 2. 2 factorial upon s power 2 plus 1. 2 power upon s cube. Laplace of 1 by 2 is constant. Laplace of t square is 2 upon s cube. 2, 2 cancel out, which is 1 upon s cube. Which is 1 upon s cube. Now, here we have to understand one important thing is, what is mean by impulse? This is the most important thing. What is mean by impulse? See, I will explain some of the examples, try to understand. Anil Kumble is Indian main coach, Indian cricket main coach. 2 days back, take an impulsive decision. What is the impulsive decision taken by Anil Kumble? He told, I am having some differences with Indian cricket captain Virat Kohli, that's why I am away from the coach position. That means I am unable to continue the coach position. He resigned for that job. That is nothing but impulsive statement. Means sudden, surprising statement. One more thing. Mahendra Singh Dhoni take an impulsive decision about test career during Australian Open Series. That means whenever all Indian cricketers went to Australia 2 years back, Mahendra Singh Dhoni suddenly retired from test career. That is also impulsive decision. Sudden decision, nothing but impulsive. Assumption. One of our friends, those who are listening today class, One of our friend has thought we'll get just 75 marks out of 100 in 2018 GATE. But fortunately, the person who thought about 75 maybe is the topper in all India. Maybe in one of our friend of today's listening class will become topper in electrical stream or anyone in electronic stream or anyone in instrumentation stream. Ultimately, they will become surprise. They will become shock. That is impulsive. Impulsive means sudden or shock, which is natural or artificial. Natural. Therefore, impulse signal is also called natural signal. Impulse signal is also called natural signal. Right? That is treated as, this is mathematical representation. Del of t. At t is equal to 0, the response is very, very high, which is equal to infinity. We can't define that response. Suddenly, thunder is falling to ground from the sky. That is impulsive, sudden shock. What is the intensity of the thunder, which can't be measured, which is infinite current? That appears within short span of time. That means, at t is equal to 0, the response of thunder is very high. But after t is equal to 0, the signal disappears, which is natural, but not artificial. Thunder is natural, but not artificial, right? This is infinity, but for understanding, we are writing practically the impulsive signal is 1, not be infinity. Next, this is natural signal is also called impulsive signal, which is not forced signal. Whereas unit step, in our home fan is there. At t is equal to 0, right now t is equal to 0, that means 2 o'clock time, right now assumption, time is 2 o'clock, at 2 o'clock exactly I switched on the fan. Whenever 2 o'clock I exactly switch on the fan, I want to sleep up to 6 p.m., therefore 2 to 6, the fan is running by constant speed. It is the position of off, it is the position of on. Suddenly switch is on. From off position to on, by that fan is running constant speed. That is represented by force. Force, see, I am going to be switch on the fan. That means force signal. It is not natural, not it's by own. Manually it is operating. That's why it is force signal. That's why it is force signal. Or else, midnight 12 o'clock, I am going to switch on the fan. It is going to be run constant up to 6 a.m. early morning. 12 to 6, the position of the fan is from on to off to on. Changing the position from off to on, this is represented by step signal, which is constant but not variable, right? Which is force signal because I forcefully switched on the fan, but not running naturally like a thunder. Next, ramp signal. Ramp signal is nothing but linear signal, like t power 1, linear signal. That means variation of output, variation of input, both are linear or proportional, both are obeys Ohm's law or superposition. What is the meaning of superposition? Both are varying proportionally or linearly. That is represented by ramp signal. This is also forced signal. Next, parabolic signal. In parabolic signal, variation of input and output is not linear, which are non-linear. That means, ramp signal example is, I am teaching control system, you are listening. Both are moving in proportionally. Whereas in parabolic signal, I am teaching, you are sleeping. Or you are listening, I am sleeping and teaching. Which is non-linear relationship, can be represented by parabolic signal. These are all the physical behavior of the signals. Impulse is natural signal, just appears and disappears within short span of time like thunder. Remaining all the signals are forced signals. Total how many basic signals? 4 basic signals. First one is impulse. Second is unit step. Third ramp. Fourth parabolic. As impulse is natural signal, remaining all 3 are forced signals. This is about physical behavior of signals. Physical behavior of signals. Now, if I take one impulse signal, this is one impulse, two impulse signals, three, four, I am taking the impulse signal like this. By keep on adding the magnitude of this impulse signals, will become a straight line, constant line. This is impulse signal, impulse. By adding all impulse signal will become a step signal. Therefore, addition of impulse signal, addition means integration. Integration of impulse will become step signal. Integration of impulse signals with respect to time is called step signal. Integration of impulse signal will become unit step. Integration of step signal, integration of 1 by s will be 1 by s square. Integration of all step signal will become ramp signal. Integration of step will become ramp signal. Integration of 1 by s square, it is integration of 1 t. Integration of t, t square by 2, that is parabolic signal. Integration of ramp signal will become parabolic signal. Most important with respect to gate exam, IES and IAS. Everything we have to go by clear and manner, right? Now, integration of impulse signal is step signal. Integration of step signal is ramp signal. Integration of ramp signal is parabolic signal. Now, differentiate both the sides. Integration will go this side, step, differentiation. Integration is going this side, differentiation. Now reverse. Differentiation of step signal. Integration is coming this side, differentiation. Differentiation of step is impulse. Once again, integration comes this side. Differentiation. Differentiation of ramp will become opposite, step. Integration coming this side will become differentiation. Differentiation of parabolic will become ramp signal. These are the formulas we have to remember for gate, IAS and IAS exams and central government questions. Integration of impulse, step. Integration of step, ramp. Integration of ramp, parabolic. Differentiation of parabolic, ramp. Differentiation of ramp, unit step. Differentiation of step, impulse. That's all. By down it is integration, by up it is differentiation. Now, impulse will become step through integration process. Integration of impulse is step. Here, impulse is becoming step by multiplying 1 by s. 1 into 1 by s will become 1 by s. Here impulse will become step through integration. Here impulse will become step by multiplying 1 by s to 1. Therefore, here integration, here 1 by s will become same. 1 by s will be called as integrator. 1 by s is called as integrator. Next. Step become ramp by integration. Step 1 by s becoming ramp by multiplying 1 by s. Step will become ramp by multiplying 1 by s. 1 by s into 1 by s, 1 by s square. Therefore, 1 by s here, here integrator. Both are same. 1 by s square becoming 1 by s cube by multiplying 1 by s. And 1 by s square means ramp. Ramp will become parabolic by integration. Here also 1 by s means integrator. Next. 1 by s cubed become 1 by s square. Means parabolic become ramp by multiplying s. S into 1 by s cubed is 1 by s square. That means parabolic becoming ramp by differentiation. Here 1 by s cubed becoming 1 by s square by s. Therefore, s is treated as differentiator. S is treated as differentiator. In our control system language, wherever s is there, that will be treated as differentiator. Wherever 1 by s is there, that will be treated as integrator. Next, ramp. What is ramp? 1 by s square. 1 by s square ramp is becoming step, that is 1 by s by multiplying s. Now tell me s into 1 by s square, 1 by s. Here, ramp becoming step through differentiation. Here, 1 by s square ramp becoming step by s. Therefore, s is differentiator. Finally, step becoming impulse. 1 by s becoming 1 by multiplying s. 1 by s into s, 1. That means step becoming impulse through derivative. Here also, s is nothing but differentiator. Now, what you have to understand is, s is differentiator and 1 by s is integrator. Integration of impulse. Integration. Or else, you know, integration, what is the first letter? I. Impulse, what is the first letter? I step. Means, I means integration of impulse is step. Next, impulse, integration of step, ramp. Integration of ramp, parabolic. Next, opposite. Differentiation of step, impulse. Differentiation of ramp, step. Differentiation of parabolic, ramp. That's all. Where 1 by s is integrator and s is differentiator. In this way, we have to proceed. These are the basics about signals and systems. Four signals, among four signals, impulse is natural signal. Remaining step, ramp, parabolic, all three are forced signals. Next, some of the basic concepts. Transfer function is applicable only for LTI systems. This is reference input R of T. Control output C of T. What is mean by LTI system? L means linear. Input and output variations both are proportional. Then only we will analyze the system. Time invariant. With respect to time, output is not variable, which is constant. It is time invariant. If you are multiplying these two signals, the result will be like this. Instability, we'll discuss this. Third topic. Maybe Tuesday we'll complete this. That signal will become bounded signal. Bounded signal means reaches to steady state. Then only we'll analyze this. Nonlinear signal. This is nonlinear. With respect to time, it is not linear. It is changing with respect to. Here slope is constant everywhere. But here slope is not constant. It is nonlinear signal. It is unbounded signal also. Time variant, like with respect to time, output is variable. These two signals we can't analyze right now. But these two signals also we'll analyze in control system, that is in modern control system. But in classical control system, initial conditions are zero as well as applicable only for LTI systems. Transfer function is applicable only for LTI systems. Second one, it is applicable SISO systems. It is applicable for SISO systems. What is the meaning of SI? Single input and SO is single output systems. Transfer function is valid for SISO systems and it is applicable for only LTI systems. Transfer function is valid only for LTI systems and is applicable for SISO systems. Next, among all the inputs, that is in signals and systems, among all the inputs we have only one input as natural input, that is impulse input. With respect to that, we have to discuss right now transfer function. It is a system input is impulse, then output is also impulse. What is the meaning of this is, as input is sudden shock, impulse means sudden shock. As input is sudden shock, definitely output of the system also sudden shock. Impulse means sudden or shock, surprise, sudden surprise, immediate. Definitely output also immediate, sudden shock. Right? That is the reason why the output of the system is also called impulsive output. Output, another name is called response. Therefore, it is impulse response or impulsive response. As input of the system is impulsive or sudden input, definitely output also sudden output or sudden shock, also called impulse output, also called impulsive response. Let's take example. Input is del of t, means impulse. This is transfer function. System means transfer function, transferring energy. Output is e power minus 2t. Then what is transfer function? Laplace of output to the Laplace of input by assuming initial conditions are zero. This is the definition. What is output? Laplace of e power minus 2t divided by input is Laplace of del of t, which is Laplace of e power minus 2t. What is Laplace of del of t? 1. This side transfer function. So what we have to understand here is, whenever input is impulse, then transfer function becomes Laplace of output. What is e power minus 2t? Output. Output is also called impulse output, also called impulsive response. Therefore, this is called impulsive response. That's all. All these discussions not required. Simply, if input is sudden shock, output also sudden shock. Input is impulse input, output is impulse output, called impulse response. Therefore, transfer function called impulse response, Laplace of impulse response. Now, second definition of transfer function is, second definition, definition 2. Already definition 1 of transfer function, ratio of Laplace of output to Laplace of input by assuming initial conditions are 0. What is the second definition of transfer function is? Transfer function is Laplace of impulse response. Simply, definition is transfer function is a Laplace of impulse response by assuming initial conditions are 0. By assuming initial conditions are 0. That's all. These are the two definitions. See, first definition, transfer function is Laplace of output to the Laplace of input by assuming initial condition 0. Second definition, Laplace of impulse response or impulse output. Right? Substitute this one in above case. In place of transfer function, substitute this one. Laplace of impulse response is equal to Laplace of output divided by Laplace of input. Substituting in place of this. Right? From second, impulse response is equal to, it is coming this side, it will become inverse Laplace, L inverse of transfer function. L inverse of transfer function. Now tell me, transfer function is Laplace of output to Laplace of input, second. Transfer function is Laplace of impulse response, third. Laplace of impulse response is equal to Laplace of output by Laplace of input. Finally, impulse response is equal to inverse Laplace of transfer function. That's all. These four formulas are most necessary while solving signals and system problems in control system. It is also part of our subject, not beyond this. I hope you understand. Once again, we will repeat. There are four signals in signals and systems. One is impulse, step, ramp, parabolic. Impulse is natural. Remaining three are force signals. Integration of impulse becomes step. Integration of step becomes ramp. Integration of ramp becomes parabolic. Reverse. Differentiation of parabolic will become step. Sorry, ramp. Differentiation of ramp will become step. Differentiation of step will become impulse. Next, as there are four natural, okay, 1 by s is integrator, s is differentiator, I have proved that. Next, among four signals, one is natural signal, that is impulse. Therefore, we have to know the behavior of impulse signal with respect to transfer function. As we applied impulse input, Laplace of impulse input become 1. Whenever it is 1, the transfer function become Laplace of output. That output, as input is impulse, output also impulsive. Therefore, transfer function is called Laplace of impulse response. This is second definition. First definition is Laplace of output by Laplace of input. Second definition is Laplace of impulse response. By equating transfer function as Laplace of impulse response, I have created third formula. From this, impulse response is inverse Laplace of transfer function. There are four formulas. And if question is asking, if in the question, if input and output is given, calculate transfer function means take first formula. If impulse response is given, calculate transfer function means second formula. Input and impulse or output and impulse, in these three, any two is given, we have to use third formula. Suppose if you know transfer function, how to calculate impulse, fourth formula, right? Among these four formulas, signals and system questions are variable, right? Now we'll discuss some of the questions. Question number one from signals and systems. Impulse response is 5 e power minus 2t into u of t. Then transfer function is. See friends. Now only we have discussed four formulas. Transfer function is Laplace of output by Laplace of input. Second one, transfer function means Laplace of impulse response. Third one, impulse response is inverse Laplace of transfer function. Fourth formula, Laplace of impulse response is equal to Laplace of output upon Laplace of input. Among these four formulas, to the given question, which is suitable. He given impulse response, we have to calculate transfer function. That means I have to use second formula. Impulse response given, we have to calculate transfer function. Therefore, second formula. In second formula, what is transfer function? Laplace of impulse response. Laplace of 5 into e power minus 2t. 5 is constant, Already we know Laplace of e power minus 2t, formula of Laplace of e power minus ad, in place of ad is 2, it is plus. Already explained all these formulas. Go through, you will get the answer. 5 upon s plus 2. This is the solution for this question. Next. Next question. Transfer function is 1 upon s square plus 3s plus 2. Then impulse response is reverse question. We know transfer function. Right now we have to calculate impulse. That means we have to use third formula. Which formula? Third formula. Like this, in signals and system, if any question is there, if you are confusing, write four formulas or write in your brain. Means you have to keep in your brain. Any question is there, immediately you have to recollect from that brain. Use that formula. Without any hesitation, you will complete solution. Right? Now impulse response. But there is no direct formula. First of all, tell me, what is impulse response formula is? Inverse Laplace of transfer function. First of all, there is no L inverse of 1 upon s square plus 3s plus 2. It is second order equation because denominator is 2. Therefore, there is no direct formula for this inverse Laplace. We have to go for partial fractions. 1 upon s square plus 3s plus 2. Partial fractions can be written as 1 upon s plus 1 into s plus 2. Like this. We can write like this. A upon s plus 1 plus b upon s plus 2. A upon s plus 1 plus b upon s plus 2. A is very clear, defining at s plus 1 equal to 0. B is very clear, defining at s plus 2 equal to 0. Whatever under the term is there, at that time it is defining. That means it is defining at s equal to minus 1. It is defining at s equal to minus 2. Already A is at 1 upon s plus 1. Without 1 upon s plus 1, what is there? 1 upon s plus 2. Direct substitute here. Remove s plus 1, remaining 1 upon s plus. Substitute s equal to minus 1. Minus 1 plus 2, 1. 1 upon 1, 1. Next, B. Already s plus 2 is there. Remove this. Next, 1 by s plus 1. Substitute s value as minus 2. Minus 2 plus 1, minus 1. 1 by minus 1, minus 1. Now, L inverse of A upon s plus 1 plus B upon s plus 2. Substitute A and B values. L inverse A value 1 upon s plus 1. B value minus 1 upon s plus 2. L inverse of 1 by s plus 1. It is e power minus t. 1 upon s plus 2 is e power minus 2t into u of t is inbuilt function. U of t is inbuilt function. 1 by s plus t, 1 by s plus 2. What is Laplace of e power minus 2t? 1 by s plus 2. Similarly, inverse Laplace of 1 by s plus 2 is e power minus 2t. Reverse. That's all. So, partial fractions also very easy. If A is defining at this, what is the remaining function? 1 by s plus 2. As B is defining at this, what is the remaining function? 1 by s plus 1. According to that, we have to complete. Next question. Impulse response of an linear time invariant system or simply LTI system, linear time invariant system, is e power minus 2t into u of t, where t greater than 0. to produce a response means output of t e power minus 2t into u of t, where t greater than 0, the input must be equal to this question is repeated first in gate, then IES, once again gate, then AP Transco, ABS Enco, state government, central government, n number of times this question repeated. See, in control system the questions are repeating because unable to form new questions, everything will be closed. If they are forming new questions, they have to change the numerical data. For that we will complete the solution. I will definitely 100% guarantee warranty you will get full marks in control system after listening my class, right? Each and every moment is most important. Now, impulse response, IR means impulse response, is given e power minus 2t and produce a response. Response means output, t e power minus 2t. Output is given, impulse is given. Then we have to calculate the input. That means last formula. What is last formula? From that formula, Laplace of input is equal to Laplace of output upon Laplace of impulse response. That's all. Just I'm changing these positions. Laplace of input, Laplace of impulse response. Now, Laplace of output, t into e power minus 2t. Laplace of impulse, e power minus 2t. Already explained. Laplace of t power n, e power minus at. What is the formula? N factorial upon s plus a whole power n plus 1. Here, Laplace of t e power minus 2t. In place of n, 1 is there. In place of a, just 2 is there. 1 upon s plus 2 whole power 1 plus 1, 2. That's all. 1 upon s plus 2 square. Laplace of e power minus 2t is 1 upon s plus 2. These two cancel out. What is the question? Just input is asking, not the Laplace of input. Lot of people are tempting here. Be alert while reading control system questions. You must go through each and every part and every letter, right? Just we required input, not Laplace of input. Therefore, input is equal to, L is going that side, will become L inverse of, what is remaining? 1 upon s plus 2. What is L inverse 1 by s plus 2? E power minus 2t into u of t. This much input is required to produce a response of t, e power minus 2t. I hope you understand this. Right? Next question. Impulse response of the given system is, impulse response of the given system is, impulse response of the given system is. See, this is a cascade connection. Cascade connection means output of this first system, 1 by s, input, gain, then output. Output of the system is B, input to the system. Assumption output is here. After 1 by s, I'm taking output. This output of this previous system act as an input to another system or next system, sorry, input to the next immediate system is called cascade connection. What is cascade connection means? Output of previous system will act as an input to the next system, immediately next system is called cascade connection. Whenever the blocks are in cascade, the result will be multiplication in control system. Therefore, output in now result is 1 upon s into s plus 1. This is called transfer function. Means whatever internal gain is nothing but that is transfer function. What is the question? Impulse response. We know how to calculate impulse from transfer function. Already we have a formula. In four formulas, this formula is suitable. Check it. Impulse response is inverse Laplace of transfer function. Now, inverse Laplace of 1 upon s into s plus 1. Formula, direct formula not available. Therefore, go for partial fractions. 1 upon s into s plus 1 can be written as a upon s plus b upon s plus 1. A upon s plus b upon s plus 1. A is defined at s equal to 0. As s is already, a is defined at s, therefore what is the remaining function? 1 by s plus 1. Substitute, 1 by s is 0. 0 plus 1, 1. 1 by 1, 1. Next, b. B is defined at s plus 1 equal to 0, which becomes s equal to minus 1. Already is defining at s plus 1, that b is defining at s plus 1. What is the remaining function? 1 by s. Substitute s value, 1 by minus 1, which is minus 1. Substitute here. L inverse A upon S plus B upon S plus 1. L inverse, what is A? 1 upon S, B minus 1 upon S plus 1. L inverse of 1 by S, 1 minus. Already we know, what is Laplace of 1? 1 by S. Similarly, inverse Laplace of 1 by S, 1. 1 by S plus 1, e power minus t into u of t. Even you are writing u of t, not writing u of t, there is no issue because it is an inbuilt signal that you will understand in signals and systems. This is next question. I hope all you people are following all these standards. Next, input to the system is unit step to produce an output t square e power minus t. Then the transfer function is, right, is given input as unit step, output is t square e power minus t, is a direct question. What is transfer function? Laplace of output to the Laplace of input. What is output? T square e power minus t, input is unit step u of t, or simply 1 into u of t, right? Is like t power n e power minus a t. T square t power n e power minus a t. T power n e power minus a t formula is n factorial, 2 factorial upon s plus a. In place of a, 1 into t, 1. 2 plus 1, n plus 1 is 2 plus 1 cube divided by Laplace of 1, 1 by s. S goes to numerator, 2 into s upon s plus 1 whole cube. This is the transfer function of the given system. So, we are ending our subject discussion here. After break, we'll discuss questions.